opportunity to present on the youth portion of our regional plan. Hopefully. Our board has a mission to make sure that Northwest Indiana workforce is highly skilled, motivated, diverse, and earning sustainable or higher wages, and that they're actively engaged in skill advancement and lifelong learning even after they come through our programs. We want to mobilize and integrate the leadership, services, and resources of our community, in my SWIC community, Region 1, to support workforce development. The core objectives of our board are to increase the skills of our current workforce, making sure they're aligned with economic development strategies. We want to improve and improve access to those qualified workers and make sure they're aware of training resources available to them or that we provide to the workers. We want to ensure that our youth in Northwest Indiana are positioned for continued success and also lifelong learning. We want to encourage and support an entrepreneurial spirit. And we want to ensure that there's compliance and efficient operations of our workforce development system. As we mentioned before, we want to make sure that our workers are skilled and qualified. And to do so, we looked at the drivers of our economy, and our key industry clusters in Region 1 are manufacturing, healthcare, transportation, distribution, logistics, construction, and hospitality, entertainment, arts, retail, and tourism. We have some casinos and other things up in our area. What is good about this, these key industry clusters are perfect for youth for not only entry-level positions, but also if they get some short-term training, they can get maybe mid-level positions and a higher wage. We do have a lot of training in these areas as well. The goals of our youth and young adult, as we call some of our older out-of-school youth, programming our career exploration resulting in career pathways. We, in our region, we've built an online platform. We call it the Career Decision Making Course. It is a collection of local, regional, state, and national resources available for our youth. It starts with them taking the Indiana Career Explorer, to assess what their career interests are. They then, once they decide, they take the top two industry clusters, and they are provided a collection of resources. We have them do research using Hoosier data, but looking at the hot 50 jobs, they might go to O-Net. We have asked them to register in Indiana Career Connect, and there is a youth section where they can get other links for other resources. And then we also recently have done videos with local employers that we ask them to watch. So they get an idea of what the industry is all about, what kind of jobs are in that industry, and what skills you need to have those. And then we move on to practical application, and that includes kind of practicing before they do things. We implemented simulations with our youth. If you know Sims, so we have them do customer service. There's a call center, there's sales, and then we have a virtual cash drawer, which I practice in sales, so I cannot go into cover. And then once they finish that, then we put them into some type of work-based learning activity, whether it's a work experience, an internship, their career leads them to go into a pre-apprenticeship or on a job training. Our other goal is to make sure that our youth are prepared for 21st century skills, make sure that they have those job skills they need and the soft skills they might refer to as work ethics. We want to make sure that they get the credentials they need to succeed. And then finally, placement into employment or post-secondary. So we have procured two providers to implement our youth program. JobWorks will be implementing our in-school JAG program. And then we are piloting a program called Career Pathways. It's for youth that are co-enrolled with adult ed. So all the youth in that program are adult ed students. And then they'll also provide individualized services and activities. And our other provider is Google Industries in Michigan. They're going to implement the out-of-school JAG program. We have currently one program. 8 schools, 9 programs, and our targeted enrollment is expected to be 360. And as the Edlers have mentioned, so I won't go into a lot of detail, JAG is a year-round program. We're going to spend 25% of our budget on it, and then we will specifically address those 5 new program elements. The labor market information is really through that our career decision-making online course. Tutoring they get through the school, well, they'll be exposed to work experience, leadership development they get, financial literacy and entrepreneurship, preparation, transition to post-secondary education, support services. Those are already really incorporated in the school model. I will say that we're very committed to the JAG program. We still have 3 programs that were part of the original 12 when JAG was first launched in Indiana. And we want to make sure the community knows about JAG. So we launched a monthly newsletter last fall, and you all have copies of it. And it's written by the students. And it not only talks about what they're doing in the program, but their other achievements, if they excel in track or sports, and what's going on in their lives. Is the one you have at the end of the year. And it talks about those that have already graduated and gone on and what are they doing now. And this letter goes out to principals, superintendents, local elected officials, and other community organizations. And we just feel it's a good way for the community to connect to our JAG program. Our out-of-school youth, we're projected to serve a minimum of 650 youth this year. And that's pretty much on par with what we did this year. So, or last year, this last program. Those 650 will include our out-of-school JAG participants, those that go into that career pathway program, and then others that might receive individual services and activities. This will also be year-round. Our 75% of our budget will be spent on this. And this is really where we want to focus more on those 5 new program elements, especially entrepreneurship, financial literacy, and then transition to either post-secondary education, work-based learning, education offered concurrently. That's the really big one. And our outputs include work experiencing, training completion, skills gain, and entry into employment. So one of the things we really wanted to focus on with those 5 program elements, is to increase the opportunities for stackable credentials while participating in other youth activities and services. What we really want to do is shorten the amount of time it takes. A lot of our youth tend to do things in sequential order. They might be getting working on a high school diploma or high school equivalency, and then they leave and go to work, and then they come back. We really feel the Career Pathway Program is an excellent opportunity for them to earn different things and participate in activities. So our youth staff are actually on site at the adult ed location. The adult ed teachers are working on them with their academic skills to get their high school equivalency diploma or brush up on their basic skills. And our youth staff are offering career activities such as work experience. Our youth provider is also providing a customer service and a leadership online certificate for them, for the class, and then work-based learning. And then from there, they can go on to their OJT or some occupational training. So instead of doing sequential, we're trying to combine it more stackable. We would like to do a lot of additional e-learning courses in other areas such as financial literacy and entrepreneurship. We have the hands-on baking. But we recently introduced also the, I can't remember the name of that one from the Hoosier Data. In reality, they really liked that. But we want to find other things. We find a lot of youth like technology versus the lecture classroom setup for our out-of-school youth. And we want to make sure that the out-of-school youth are getting their customer service and leadership skills. And then finally, additional transactions. Activities for both employment and post-secondary education. We focus a lot on that with in-school youth, but I really think we need to work on that with our out-of-school youth, especially we we want to make sure they're prepared both with the job skills and those other skills, soft skills, but also, like, what are you going to do when you don't, you have to wait 2 weeks to get your first paycheck? We want to make sure that they're successful in retaining either into employment or post-secondary education. Our out-of-school youth success indicators, of course, for the career pathways, we want them to complete the course. If they're a dropout, we want them to get the high school equivalent food diploma. Participation in work-based learning activities. We would like all our youth to do that. That's not always possible, but there's some ways we can do that is through simulations, through job shadowing, tours of companies. But at least 20% of our graduate will be used for work experiences, pre-apprenticeships, or on-the-job training. And then we want all of our youth to have some level of certificate or credential, whether it's the high school level or even a certificate of achievement or some industry recognized certification, just so that they can pull it together for a future employer. Of course, we want to meet the WIOE published mentors. That's one of our goals. And return on investment. Plan to compare our expenditures to our results. And we feel that partnerships are key to our success in achieving these goals. As I've already mentioned, we have a great partnership with Adult Ed. The adult staff are providing that academic basic skill support. Our youth staff are providing that workforce preparedness, and they're both coming together to provide career exploration and career services. We were also lucky enough to partner this year with Junior Achievement. They trained our JAG staff on their entrepreneur and financial literacy. Mm-hmm. So the JAG staff are actually delivering those into the classroom, and they loved it. They asked for feedback. So we're going to continue that partnership. And then we also, our providers also have provided us with some non-WIOA resources, such as the leadership classes, the customer service, and there's a work readiness class that they're going to provide for us. And then we feel it's really important for professional development. We meet a lot with our youth staff, but we've also pulled in our adult ed teachers because the outcomes for both partners are the same, but their perspective is different. So we oftentimes bring in someone, we had someone from McGraw Hill talk about the task, and it was interesting to see the perspective of the adult ed teacher versus the youth staff and how they can work together to share the outcome.
That's a good idea.
And then we also had someone come in to provide a youth worker certification for our youth staff, but we also had adult ed staff, Leslie and Brianna were there, and then we also had some teachers, our principals. And we try to meet about 3 times a year with the adult ed and youth staff. And finally, this would not all be possible without our board, and we had a youth council, and we continue to transition to the youth committee. So we want to make sure youth are positioned for continuous education, learning, and workforce success. They want to align education with the needed business skills, help youth and young adults understand the skills needed to make it in the workforce. And some of the key initiatives we're doing, it's my first job article series. We have some prominent individuals throughout our region that actually talk about what they did, their first job, and then how that job helped shape them and help them become the person they are today. And we have a first job hiring campaign that's really a summer initiative where we ask employers to give youth that first job, take a chance on them, whether it's odd jobs, whether it's just temporary, whatever it might be. We want to make sure there's a work-based opportunities for all youth. And then we have a work ethic strategy for schools and for youth. So if there's any questions.
One behind you.
Oh, sorry.
How often do you send out your newsletter?
It's monthly.
Monthly?
I'll send you one. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We'll make sure that you can make it by now.
Okay. Well, Rusty for the summer, but each month is a school does one of our programs does it. And so they'll talk about we kind of put in the schools can feature how many have gotten into school, where they've gotten into post-secondary scholarships they've earned, if some were inducted to the honor society. We actually had basically had three programs, two had valedictorians, and one had salutatorian of their class. So we wanted to make sure we recognized them. And then at the end of the last, this was our last edition, so we did a Where Are They Now?
Do you know one other thing? I don't want to talk all the time, but that are two things that you came up with, but I wonder, you talked about the videos, which I saw one of those videos and they're excellent. Then you talked about the My First Job where you get the guys to talk about that. In some schools they have announcements every day and they, you know, on TV, and I just think it would be really fun for the schools perhaps to have some of those that they could just show and keep that whole idea of your first job, get that, like, get kids thinking about jobs, but the fact that there's more to school than just finishing school, but like to get them thinking forward. That's just an idea.
Integrated into the school website for us.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes. All those videos have been, the videos have been made offered to the schools. So schools have access. Our CWI is lucky enough to have another initiative that's called Ready Northwest Indiana. It's really preparing youth through that pipeline and working with Career and Tech Ed, and they're the ones that really develop these videos. So all the schools have videos, and it can be on construction, it can be on manufacturing.
That's so great.
Here.